Hi. Hello there. I'm very happy to be here and very excited again to speak to you about the bariatric surgery and the types of bariatric surgery. 2 weeks ago, we had a guest in our studio, Dr. Bariatric Surgeon Olegs Kozlovskis, and we were speaking about gastric sleeve surgery, its techniques and outcomes and new questions. Today, we're going to speak about gastric bypass surgery, which is still gold standard in bariatric surgery. And we again have our super bariatric surgeon in the studio, Dr. Olegs Kozlovskis. So I'm giving the word to him, and let's speak about the gastric bypass surgery, and you can write your questions under the window. So let's start. Hello, doctor.
Yeah, hello, Ilva. Hello, everybody. Thank you for having me today. And today our topic is gastric bypass. And I will try briefly to describe what I am feeling like a surgeon during the surgery, why we are choosing a gastric bypass like a procedure. And we will go through all the steps during the surgery. I think it's very important to know what we are surgeons doing with your body and why it's very necessary. So I would like to start with a few words that bypass still a gold standard in the world. And on a conference, when some speakers ask surgeon who like bypass, everybody hold hands up. So bypass is very good procedure and very well known procedure, and the history of this procedure is starting in 60s in last century, and it's still going. So what we're doing during this procedure, first of all, it's a procedure under general anesthesia, like all bariatric procedure, when patient is in an operating room. Anesthesiologist team working very hard with this patient, preparing everything, putting intubation tube in your windpipe, putting another tube in your mouth and esophagus in the stomach. It's a very important tube. I will talk a little bit later about that. And as soon as you are sleeping and as soon as you are completely feeling nothing, we can start to do the procedure. So we are starting with insertion of optical trocar. It's special equipment which is using to go through your abdominal cavity. Some of patients have quite thick abdominal cavity. It's necessary to go through. It's necessary to go inside an abdominal cavity and insufflate CO2 to create a space for operation. So as soon as this space is created, usually I'm putting a camera inside and looking around the whole abdominal cavity if everything is okay. So first of all, I'm checking liver size, because you know, obese people suffering from fatty liver, and it's very important to lose a few kilograms before the procedure, because the first organ who are getting smaller, it's a liver, and it's important to us to put liver up and to create space for doing the surgery. So if liver is okay, there is no any problems, I make a look around the abdominal cavity, look at adhesion, look at small bowels, look at large bowel, look at the stomach. So if there is no any problems inside, we can do the procedure and we put other trocars. Usually we are using 5 trocars. Next trocars is going straight away behind your ribs, and it's a hook which is holding the left lobe of the liver up. So when this is done, we move your body with the special lens, we find out that if we change your lying position to a little bit more like you're sitting, it's create more space and much more easy to do the procedure. So we are moving the table and create more space inside. After that, we are putting other three trocars, two for walking hands and another one for assistant hands. So as soon as it was done, we check where we will going to do small pouch. So bypass procedure, it means that we I will put one build on the screen now. So here you are. So there is normal anatomy, esophagus, and first part of your stomach, this red line is where we have to create a small pouch. So firstly, we are looking for this part of the stomach. There is very good blood supply, and we have to divide small some vessels, and we need to get under the stomach. So we use special devices to divide blood vessels to be safe, so that there is no any bleeding, and we go behind the stomach. So the next step is to create also space in this region, because there are some ligamentum where which hold the stomach in a position, but we have to create their empty space so we can make a pouch. So as soon as this is done, we can start to divide stomach in two parts, small part and big part. We are using staplers. It's 45 millimeters long staplers. We usually use three staplers, sometimes four staplers. So first stapler are placed directly in this position where I'm showing now for you. We divide stomach in two parts. So we try to create a nice stomach without any tension, without any, how can I say, changing of the lens. So one stapler go there and two other staplers go there. So as soon as this small pouch is created, we are checking for a bleeding from the stapler line. Sometimes it's necessary to stop this bleeding with the clips or using some energy devices, or maybe we are putting some additional stitches on this bleeding. You know that stomach is very well supplied organ, and it's necessary to stop the bleeding very carefully. As soon as this is done, so we are going to find small intestine, because we have to create connection between stomach pouch and small intestine. In abdominal cavity, there is some big omentum with special organ with the fat. We put it up and make division in two parts. Why it's necessary? We find out that if we divide omentum in two parts, it's much more easy to reach with the small bowel this stomach pouch. There are no any additional tension. Some surgeons put this small bowel over this omentum meatus, big omentum. We find out if we divide in two parts this omentum, for small bowels, there is no any tensions anymore. So we find a beginning of the small intestine, and count approximately 60, 70 centimeters from the beginning. Beginning is there, and this part we getting up to the stalk. So we make two small holes, one in the pouch, another one in the small intestines, and we are insert stapler inside in both organs. So firstly, we are inserting stapler in small intestine, and after the next jaw, we inserting in a stomach. And the connection between small stomach pouch and small intestine is created with stapler. So as soon as it is done, it's necessary to check inside stapler line and also outside stapler line, because if there are some bleeding, it's necessary to stop it and to put some additional stitch on. So you remember I told that I created hole in the stomach pouch, and also I created small hole in small intestine, and this hole have to be sutured by sewing by hand. So we are using absorbable stitches to close this defect, and usually it's going from this part to medial part, and this defect is closed. We're using stitching needle holder and needles and absorbable stitch. So when this is done, so, main part of the bypass is done. So it's created small stomach pouch, and also it is connected, we call it anastomosis, it's connected with the small intestine. So after that, there is quite important part. We have to count 1.2 meters of the small intestine. So we have special instrument when we are counting each 5 centimeters of this small intestine, and we find out another point where will be a second connection done. So usually it's 1.2 meters. So after that, we use another cartridge of linear stapler, and we are connecting two small intestine loop, because it's necessary all the juices from the big stomach. You can see that big stomach is disconnected, and but it's still producing the juices. After the stomach is duodenum, also in duodenum is small hole where pancreas juice and bile is opening. It's not hole, it's opening, and all the juices have to go back to gastrointestinal tract. So the second connection is very important for this operation, and it's also have to be done. So the technique is quite the same. So I create two small holes in both bowels by an energy device, and I put a linear stapler inside and hold it. And when the stapler is fired, connection is created, but it's still small hole in one part, and this small hole it's have to be sutured by stitch. So the same, we're using absorbable stitch there and suture all the connection line, because there is no any other holes anymore in anastomosis, so they are closed. So when it's done, generally bypass is ready. There are some other few point, because when you move bowel inside in abdominal cavities, they are created few spaces where internal hernia can occur. We call one of the spaces mesenterial window, and another one like Peterson space or Peterson window. In the beginning, we didn't close these windows, but we find out that in 7% of patients can create internal hernia, and bowel can move in these windows inside, and after they are blocked. So since 2012 or 13, we started to close this mesenterial defect. That's why we are writing for all patients that mesenterial space suturation and Peterson space suturation inside. So we are using non-absorbable stitch to close these defects, and it's closed safely, and no any more bowels, they cannot go through the defects inside. No herniation are possible anymore. When this is done, it's a very important point of operation. It's necessary to check if connections are okay. So we are putting a tube. You remember in the beginning of my talk, I told that anesthesiologist putting special tube inside, and we close small bowel here, we hold it, and we are putting around 60, 80 milliliters of water to see if there are some defects, some hole in the suture lines. The small stomach become full, and we are looking carefully on the suture line. If there are some dehiscence, if there are some leakage, we have to close this with some additional stitches. And it's very important, because if we are not checking suture line in the future, a few days later can occur leakage in the suture line. So if we checked and everything is okay, we are looking one more time around if there is no any bleeding, if everything is okay, and if there are no bleeding, if we are happy with these connections, so we can finish the operation. Before we finishing, we extract all this instrument out from the stomach, and we check one more time if the K holes are safe now, if there are no any bleeding around. So when we discharge instruments, we take off CO2 from the abdominal cavity, and operation is ready. So probably everybody interested in the question when and why you recommend bypass, or how the criteria for this operation. So bypass is recommended if patient is with BMI more than 40, and also with BMI more than 35, if there are some comorbidities like diabetes 2 or some high blood pressure. So when I'm choosing bypass or sleeve, first of all, I'm looking on examination like gastroscopy. Because if patient suffered from gastroesophageal reflux disease, gastric bypass will be more likely recommended. After bypass procedure, reflux can occur in very rare percent of patients. So if a patient had some previous operation like hernia repairs or some other operation, and there are a lot of adhesions, of course I am looking if it's possible to divide these adhesions, and if it's possible to do a bypass in this situation. If it is possible, and if patient have high BMI, bypass will be done. If it's quite dangerous to divide the adhesions, if it's too much, so probably I will switch in sleeve procedure. So if it's more higher BMI. I would more likely recommend bypass for patient. If it's less BMI, if it's like BMI 35, it's mild comorbidities and young ladies, maybe I would say sleeve it's a better choice for the situation. Yes,
I have a question. Yes, mm-hmm. And you're doing two types of gastric bypass surgeries. One, you're doing it a bit differently for patients with diabetes type 2. So can you tell about the difference?
Yeah, so I will put this build on. So there are some researches done is that if we change a little bit length of these limbs for the diabetic patient, resolution of diabetes is a little bit better. So what's the change? So I describe for you standard gastric bypass where this part of bowel is around 70 centimeters and this part of bowels is 1 meter 20 centimeters, 1.2 meters. So it's regular bypass. If patients is suffering from type 2 diabetes, we change length a little bit. We make longer biliary pancreatic limb. We reach it around 1 meter, 10 centimeters. And this part would be around 19 centimeters. Why is that? Because food, indigest food will get inside in this part. But if we look in normal anatomy, this part will be much more further from the regular bypass one. So let's count together. In regular bypass, this part, I mean this part where I create connection here will be just only 17 centimeters from the beginning of small bowel. But in diabetic patients, it will be much further, 110 centimeters. Connection. So indigest food will get inside further in a small bowel and it increase hormonal response much more faster and glycemia control and resolution of type 2 diabetes is much better. So there are some two differences of gastric bypass, which we are using in our clinic. Okay, maybe you've got some other questions. How is activity today?
Everyone says hi, no questions so far. But I wanted, maybe we can speak also about this metabolic change after the gastric bypass surgery, because one of the reasons people choose to do also the surgery is to feel less hunger. Can you tell about these metabolic changes, what the gastric bypass surgery is making and providing to patient?
Yeah, so about hunger feeling, a small pouch, when you eating, it stretches quite fast after eating, and this make a response for tissue that stomach is full, and people after bypass surgery can feel quite fast the stomach is very full, and they don't want to eat anymore. Of course, if some people try to put a little bit more food inside, it can be some difficulties and can feel some pain, some quite strong discomfort. You don't have to be afraid of that because every bypass patients have experience with this feelings. As soon as they have this experience, they know that we cannot eat so much after this procedure. So what you have to do, you have just lying down and relax. It can take half an hour, 40 minutes to settle all the symptoms down. Please do not eat more than is necessary. Please do not eat more if you feel fullness of your stomach. It will cause quite severe pains in abdominal cavity.
Mm-hmm.
About metabolic changes, of course, that duodenum and big part of stomach is excluded. People have some changes with vitamins, like vitamin B12, like vitamin B1, and it's necessary to make blood tests to check your level of vitamins and to take some supplements. Also, there are some changes with the calcium, because calcium absorption also happening in duodenum, and after bypass it's excluded, and you have to take calcium usually with vitamin D. People who are living in Nordic countries, nearly everybody have low vitamin D level, and we have to get a normal level of vitamin D. It's very important. Also, sometimes can be iron deficiency, usually it's with middle-aged ladies after bariatric procedure can have some problems with the iron. But also, it's necessary to have checked the iron level, and if it's too low, it's necessary to have substitution. Sometimes it's asking to have intravenous infusion of iron.
Okay. There's a question about this sort of weight loss. What sort of weight loss is typical and the speed of weight loss? So, Risa, I cannot understand what is sort of weight loss. Can you try? But what is the average speed of weight loss after the gastric bypass surgery?
So this curve of weight loss is a line, let's say, line which is going down, but it's no going all the time down, but it's going like steps. And usually people make measurements a few times in a week in the same time, and they look how it's going down. But first few months, it's quite fast weight loss, but in the end of the year, and it's reach upper part, usually it's 1 or 1.5 years, and after this 1.5 years, it's getting a little bit regain of the weight. So as I told in first time when we met, bariatric procedure is a tool which we are giving to you to reduce the weight and to get healthier. Of course, you have to take very active part in your changing of your lifestyle and to have physical activities, and also to change your eating behavior. How weight regain will be after 1.5-2 years, it's very depend also from you, how you doing, how you are understood all this necessity, and how big changes in your lifestyle and physical activity you have done.
Yes, thank you. I will maybe add that also the risk has explained, it's like what is about the expected weight loss. It depends very much on person. So first of all, men and women lose differently. Men usually lose faster. It depends on your starting weight when you have the surgery. It depends on your physiology, your activity, your eating routines and everything. So you cannot really compare with each other, with others, and so it depends really on person. So you have to do your work and work hard, and everything will be fine. There is a question also about vitamins. Will I have problems asking my doctor to give me vitamins when I return home? Maybe you can tell about you are describing the dosages and so.
Usually you do not have, you will not have any problems if you're asking doctor for prescribing some vitamins. What is very important, it's necessary to make blood tests and to know how high level of vitamins you have. Because of these levels, you can adding some supplements, or you can stop using these supplements. And I would like to comment a little bit about this weight loss. So generally in society, in our surgical society, we have rules that if a patient after bariatric procedure lose more than 50% of excess weight, so procedure is done correctly and everything is okay. So if you take very active part after the surgery, so you can lose much more than 50%. So it's a combination of tool which you are giving to you and your response on this tool. Okay?
Yes. And about complication risks, maybe a little bit, what are the most common complications after the gastric bypass surgery?
Yeah, so like a surgeon, so we, half of our operating time, we are fighting against bleeding. So the main complication and often complication is bleeding. You know that stomach is very well blood supplied organ, and we have to be very careful with this organ because bleeding is quite dangerous and we have to stop it before we are leaving abdominal cavity. So how we prevent that? We using special clips to put on if it's possible. We make sometimes some stitches on the bleeding part of the stomach to close this, to stop this bleeding. We using a harmonic device to make decision of the tissues, and this device closing the bleeding very, very well. Sometimes bleeding can occur after the procedure, and usually it occurs first 24-48 hours. So what we're doing, we very careful looking on patient hemodynamic, if patient is stable. That's why we after the surgery immediately we are locating patient in intensive post-operative unit, and we are measuring blood pressure, we are measuring heart rate, we are looking at the patient, how they feeling. So in bypass surgery, bleeding can be, I can divide in two big parts. One part, it's if bleeding happening inside in a bowel. So a manifestation with this bleeding is passing stool with the blood. And usually this bleeding not require any second reoperation, and it's have to be treated conservatively. Sometimes we asking gastroscopist, endoscopist to look on the connection line between stomach, in stomach pouch and small intestine, and if there are some signs of the bleeding, it's possible to manage this bleeding with endoscopy tools like injection of adrenaline or with putting some clips on, sometimes coagulation. We did have bleeding when it was necessary to open connection line, and to manage this bleeding during the procedure and during the operation, because this bleeding wasn't stopped with conservative treatment, and it was necessary to open connection between small intestine, like I show you on this photo. It was second connection, and it was necessary to put some additional stitch on this bleeding. So it about bleeding inside in the bowel. Other sort of bleeding can occur if blood losing inside an abdominal cavity. So this bleeding usually require reoperation, and we have to go one more time to see inside and to clean everything out, to take this blood out. Sometimes with this complication like bleeding, it's necessary to make blood transfusion. That's why before the operation, I always ask for patient if they agree to have blood transfusion, if it's very necessary. So rate of this complication, it's between 1 and 1.5%. So it's not very often, but sometimes happening. So another complications which can be, it's wound infection. It's because we are doing the procedure in laparoscopic device, it's small holes, and infection of the wounds is not dangerous and happening very, very rare. So another complication, if you are not afraid anymore, so other complication, I'm trying to terrify you, but that's everything. So it can be leakage. Usually leakage occurs in this part where not so good blood supply, and some small hole, small opening happening. So leakage usually require second intervention, and it's necessary to put some additional stitch on or plucked this leakage with some fat tissue after this suturing, and also sometimes usually often required drainage of abdominal cavity. It's much less than 1% can occur. Other complications like pneumonia after operation, or some blood clots also can occur. Bariatric procedure is quite safe procedure, but you have to know that also can be death in around 0.03-0.05% cases. Any other questions, Ivana?
Yes. Another question. I've heard of people having problems with their gallbladders after weight loss surgery. Why is this? How common is this?
Yeah, very good question. It's a quite common condition that after bariatric surgery, people have gallstones. What we have to do with gallstones? Usually I recommend 6-9 months after operation to have another surgery, removal of gallbladder. Some people already before the surgery have got gallstones and ask us to do procedure, both procedure in one time. We usually not doing bariatric procedure. We are not mixing them with cholecystectomy. The procedure of removing of gallstones called cholecystectomy. We are removing all the gallbladder with the stones. So why it's required? It's very required after gastric bypass, because there is if the stones start to move and go inside in common bile duct, there are no any more possibilities to reach these stones through the endoscopy. There are some one treatment in normal anatomy. I will show you with the same photo. So as I told you previously, there is the opening in duodenum, in this part of the gastrointestinal tract, in this organ, there is opening of bile and also of pancreas juice. So gallbladder located there, and gallstones, if they are starting to move, people have quite big and severe pains and also just jaundice, and these stones can go there. With normal anatomy and also with the sleeve, we can put camera inside, it's called endoscopy, and we can reach this opening and make a small cut and make evacuation of the stones which is located in a common bile duct. But after gastric procedure, this is this part, after gastric bypass procedure, it's not possible to reach this part anymore because of the length of the bowels. There are some possibilities, like during the operation, we can put camera here inside and go there and remove the stones. But it's quite complicated. Because of this reason, advice is to remove stones if there are occurs, to remove them 6-9 months after operation. Another, it's just only technical reason. When you are, for example, 160 kilograms big, to remove stones, it's to remove gallbladder is very tricky. It's possible, it's common procedure, but it is much more easier to remove gallbladder if you reduce your weight. And also after gastric bypass procedure, you reduce your weight, and 6-9 months after operation, it's possible to do second surgery. The question, why happening the stones? There is no one exact answer, but I think main reason, because of the changes or changing of this bile structure and it once and another ones, it's not so nice emptying of the gallbladder. When you are eating quite regularly, this gallbladder emptying regularly, and there is no bile which is standing in the gallbladder very long. But there are some other reasons which can create stones in your gallbladder. If you are a woman and in the middle age, you have you can have gallstones more likely. If you have used some hormonal medication, you can have this gallstones more likely. If you are an obese patient, you can have this gallstones more likely. So, but one exact answer why happening and why stones occurs in your gallbladder, there is no.
Which, okay.
Yeah, any other question?
Yeah. I can't see any questions. It's 45 minutes already, so I think we could finish. I just wanted to read you from Roshan. Roshan was watching also. Hi, Olegs. 87 kilograms down. Thank you. Do you have a recommended calorie intake for patients 1+ years out? There are variations of answers. she's hearing. So yeah, there is a discussion about calorie intake after the surgery. So I think the internet is full with different information.
Yeah. Hello, Roizen. I hope you are well and you lose quite a lot. And I met you last year and you were very happy and it's very nice. And you're welcome back in Latvia just for tourism when, of course, borders will be opened. So about this calories after the procedures. Yeah, it's necessary to working very close with dietitian and with nutrition specialists, and they will advise you how to eat, what kind of food you have to intake, and how often it is necessary to do.
Yes, that's okay. Correct. So, and she's seeing the dietitian, I know, so everything will be fine. So, okay, I think I can say thank you to our surgeon. And until the next time, we will think about what issue we could discuss more. If you have any questions, please let us know, and we will answer, and we will make a video for you with your interesting questions for you. So thank you for today, and see you next time again.
Thank you very much, and see you. Bye-bye.